Linear algebra lecture 4 on subspaces by Dr. P. Ramlu, Head Department of Mathematics, MPS Government Arts and Science College, Mahabubnagar. Today I am going to discuss subspaces. Yesterday already we discussed that about the vector space and examples of that thing. So we have to reason that vector space and subspace. Let we start about the subspaces, right? What is subspace? What is subspace? I'm going to do that. Subspace. Let V over B a vector space and W be a non-empty subset of B. If W is also vector space over the same field F with vector addition and scalar multiplication of V, then W over F is also a, W over F is called subspace of V over F. But again, I am explaining, let V over F be a vector space and W be a non-empty subset of V if W is also a vector space over the field F with a vector addition and scalar multiplication of V, then W over F is called subspace of V over F. So let us discuss what happened here. This is V over F, the vector space. That means here already we proved that all vector spaces. So okay, already we have vector space, right? V over F is a vector space. This is V is the vector space over the field, right? So V over F is a vector space. I am taking one W, which is non-empty subset of V. I am taking that W subset equal to, which is non-empty. That means it is not equal to pi. So, if the V vector space over the field here F, V is the vector space over the field F. If this W also vector space over the same field F, then we say with the operations of the V, right? What is the operation of vector space? So generally we use that V complex is abelian group, and that means first operation is abelian group and second scalar multiplication, right? That is dot. Other thing is dot product, right? According to depends on set, if we see the abelian group with respect to matrix and with respect to other things, right? If we take matrix set, this is matrix addition. If we take scalar, so real number set, you can take the real numbers. If we take R2, R3, then you component wise addition. So like this, which properties, right? According to the operations of V, so then V over F is vector space. Same with the same operation, if W also vector space over the same field, then we say that W over F is vector space. Okay. W over F is a vector space. Since W is non-empty subset of V, right? W is non-empty subset of V, which implies W over F, okay, W over F is subspace of W over F is subspace of V, okay, of V over F. Okay, W over F, right? So we can look at, observe that if I am taking that V over V vector space and I am taking W, which is non-empty subset of V, if W also satisfies all vector properties over the same field with the operations of V, that means scalar addition and scalar multiplication and vector addition. So with respect to the same operations, if W is also a subspace, then we say that W over F is vector space. Okay. Simply that W over F is itself is a vector space. Simply can observe that W over F itself is a subspace. Therefore, we say that W over F is vector space, subspace of V over F. So I'm taking that example. Example. I'm taking that R over Q is a vector space. R over Q is a vector space. Yeah, I'm taking that here Q subset of R. R over Q is a vector space. Here I'm taking that Q is subset of R. This R, right? This is like V over F. I'm taking that R over Q. Here R nothing but R. Yeah, R nothing but V. W, my W is Q. My W is Q. So I'm taking that W equal to Q, W subset of Q, and already we know that Q over Q is also vector space. Therefore, Q is a subspace of R over Q. So can observe here, I'm taking my vector space is, so I'm taking that, so R over Q is a vector space. So this is my, it is look like V over F. It is look like it is same like act as vector, right? That means V nothing but V nothing but this R, F nothing but this. So what are the operations for here? We are taking the generally first R comma place. So I'm taking that R comma place. This real number R comma place is abelian group. That means first operation is vector addition. This means real line I'm taking that addition. And scalar multiplication is dot product, right? That means so extra product to C U belonging to R. So where C belonging to R, sorry, C belongs to for not true, right? C belonging to F. I'm taking that C belong U belonging to R and C belonging to Q. C belonging to Q. This C belongs to Q and U belongs to R. So this scalar addition and scalar again scalar multiplication, this is vector addition, right? So with this part already we know that. Similarly, already in first class I will discuss about the vector space. So we know that Q over Q is also a vector space. So since that reason I'm taking that one set Q, I know that Q E subset of R. Q subset of R. This is non-empty. Why? Because Q is a rational number, it has some infinite number of, so therefore Q is non-empty set subset of R. And also I know that Q over Q is vector space. Q over Q is vector space and Q subset of R. So it is the same operation. Here Q complex abelian group and this is the scalar product happened, right? So therefore we say that Q over Q is a subspace. So Q over Q is a subspace of which set? Q over Q subspace of R over Q. See, be careful when you are saying this. Why? Because see here my field is same. Q over Q is a subspace of R over Q. Why? Because here Q is same. I want to take the other set. So if I take C. C over C, sorry, C over Q is not subspace of R over Q. Q. If I take C over Q is not subset of R over Q. Why? Because C is does not subset of this C does not have set of O, R. That's why C over Q is not subspace of R work, right? If I take other thing, so I want to take that okay, I want to take other set. See, you can simply that my vector space R over Q same. My vector space R over Q is the same vector space. So, and I am taking that other subsets, right? Here I am taking other subset. We know that n, natural number n is subset of R. This subset I am taking here. R over Q is my vector space. Vector space. So this is vector space. I am taking n subset of R. So I'm going to verify that whether this says satisfy vector space or not. Right? So what about n over R? Sorry, n over Q. So I am verifying that this n over Q is a vector space or not. This is not vector space. Why? Because yesterday I already explained that V over F is vector space if simply that I am writing some property. If this vector space, if F A subset R equal to V. F is subset R equal to V. So this thing already I explained in last class. So this term is I already explained here. Simply you have to remember that V over F is a vector space if F subset equal to 1. If I take a single variable set, right, means a natural number system. If you take any number system, if you observe that whether it is vector space or not, you have to take that any field. First of all, you have to take the all fields. So you have to take any all fields. So later what you do that first of all take that if next we have to observe this, so you can take that V over F. That means here my V is also filled, F is also filled. That means like that you can take KNM, right? V over F. If F equal to this thing, F here my if I take F is filled, then that means here I'm also filled. That means so if this happen. This I said if you here if I take here field F, V is need not field. Why? Because some other set is not working for that. I'm taking that V over F is a vector space if this condition must be satisfied. You can find for vector space, right? F subset equal to F. But here if I take here, what happened here? N sub n caps, right? Whether I'm verifying that whether this vector space or not. But here Q is not subset of natural number set. Q is not set of natural number set. So it is not subset of natural number set. That's why we can say that N over Q is not vector space. It is not a vector space. So R over Q is vector space. N is subset of R. But N over Q is not vector space. Therefore, what can we say about this? So, N over Q is not vector, sorry, not subspace of R over Q. N over Q is not subspace of R over Q. Similarly, you can observe that, you may observe that W also. See, W of subset of R, right? W subset of right, we know that W subset of already we know that W subset of R, but W over Q is not vector space. Why? Because this relation is that Q is not set of W. That's why W over Q is also not subspace of R over Q. You can take Z over Q. So Z over Q, you can take that Z over Q is also not subspace of R over Q. W or Q is not subset of R over Q. Z over Q also not subset of R over Q. Okay. If I take Q, then what happened? Just now already explained. If I take Q, Q over Q is subspace of R over Q. Q over Q is subspace of R over Q, right? Why it is not subspace? Already explained that. That means you can take external. Otherwise, you can observe that why these are not vector spaces. N over Q, W over Q, Z over Q. Why these are not vector subspaces? You can simply observe that external composition property. If I take what is external composition property? If I take external composition, nothing but you can take one element from here, one element from here. If I multiply these two elements, that element belonging to this. This is external composition property. So I'm taking that one belonging to W. Okay, say the one also belongs to N, one also belongs to Z. I'm taking here 1/2. Okay, so some 1/2. One belongs to W, 1/2 does not belong to one by two belong to U. So 1 into that equal to what happened? 1/2. So but this element does not belong into which set to W. So therefore W work is not a vector space, not satisfy external composition property, therefore it is also not vector space. Similarly, you can take that one belongs to Z here. If I take here Z, same I am taking here Z, same this also does not belong into Z. If I take N, one belongs to N, so it may take when you one belongs to N. Okay. If I take N here, natural number say 1 belongs to N and 1/2 belongs to Q, 1 into 1/2 is also does not belong into N. So that means this set does not satisfy external composition property. So for the reason, category also N complex is not abelian group and VW is not an abelian group and Z complex is abelian group. But these are not abelian groups. Already we know that. So okay, for verifying abelian group, it is very taking long time. Just you can observe that external composition property. It is easy to understand that whether this vector space or not. So that's why I am taking here 1/N. N, I am taking W, Z, N, so 1 belongs to this set, so 1/2 belongs to the same set. If I multiply these two, then does not belong to this set, etc. That means, so it is not to satisfy external composition property. Then we say that it is also, these are not subspace of N. If you take here Q, you can take that same 1/1 belongs to Q, 1/2 belongs to Q. If I multiply, we will get this. Why? Because we already know that Q satisfies abelian property, so that means, so this is vector space. If I take any element here, satisfies abelian group and it satisfies all properties of vector spaces. Therefore, Q over Q is a vector space. So R over Q is a vector space. So Q subset of R. Therefore, R Q over Q is a subspace of R over Q. Right. So this way you have to understand that anyway. Right. So this kind of problems you can. Therefore, R over Q is a vector space and Q subset of R and Q over Q is also vector space. Therefore, Q over Q is subspace of R over Q. Every vector space has two trivial subspaces. They are itself and zero vector space. So if I take any subspaces, suppose V over F is a vector space. V over F is a vector space. If I take any vector spaces, it has two subspaces. Already we know that V is vector space nothing but it has it satisfies all properties of vector space, right? So this singleton zero, already we know that is a vector space over any field. Singleton zero over F is a vector space, right? And V over F is a vector space over any field, right? This thing I know. What can I ever say about this thing? So singleton 0 is subset of V. And also V subset R equal to V, just meant we can take it equal. I am writing V subset R equal to. So here V over X is a vector space. This is my vector space. I'm taking two subsets. Single time 0 is subset of V. V subset R equal to V. If I take this relation, single time 0 is a vector space. Already yesterday we discussed. If I take anything, it will satisfy vector space properties. Therefore, this is 0 vector space. This is V over vector space. V over V vector space. That means if I take any vector space, it must have two subspaces. One is 0 vector space and the other is the itself. That means if I take any subspace, any vector space, it must have two subspaces. One is itself, other is 0 vector space. So that is V over F a vector space and 0 over F and V over F or trivial subspace of V over F. That means these subspaces are called trivial subspaces, right? Other than these subspaces exist, the subspaces are called non-trivial subspaces. 0 vector space and V over F vector space are trivial subspaces. If they exist other than these subspaces, that subspaces are called non-trivial subspaces of V over F. Q over Q, if I take vector space, right? So, 0, say the singleton 0 of, right? O of Q nothing but, here my O nothing but singleton. Here O is equal to singleton 0 of, right? This O over Q and Q over Q are subspace of U over. This was the trivial subspace of E over Q. If I take R over R, is a vector space, and O over R and R over, nothing but 0 vector space and itself is vector, R, trivial subspaces. If I take C over C, is a vector space and O over C and C over C are subspace of C over C. These are the only trivial subspace of okay. If I take C over Q. If I take same field, that means Q over Q, R over R, C over C. That means my field and my say V both are same. In this case, what happened here? Oh, there exist only trivial subspaces. That is 0 subspaces and itself is a subspaces. Okay, so now I am taking here C over Q is a vector space. C over Q is a vector space. So already we know that 0 over Q and C over Q itself both are the subspaces. O over Q, C over Q. 0 vector space and these are the subspace itself. Next, Q subset of C. R is subset of C. We know that Q over Q and R over Q are vector spaces. We know that Q over Q, R over Q are vector spaces. Already yesterday discussed. And Q subset of C and R subset of C. That's why Q over Q, R over Q are subspaces of C over Q. That means O over Q, Q over Q, R over Q, C over Q are subspaces of C over Q. These O over Q and C over Q are trivial subspaces. So, Q over Q, R over Q are non-trivial subsets of C over Q. If I take C over R, so C over R is equal to 0, as is 0 subspace and this is itself subspace. It has trivial subsets, already I know that. R is subset of C, already we know that. And R over R is a vector space. R over R is a vector space. And R over is therefore 0 vector space, R over R and C over R. Subspace of C over R and this over 0 vector space R over C over R trivial subspaces R over R is non-trivial subspace of C over R. R over C is not vector space. If I take that R over C is not vector space. Not required here, I am taking that. If I take this, this is not required here. F over F, where my subspace is field. Field equal to singleton 0, 1, addition modulus 2 and multiplication modulus 2. I am taking two vector spaces. O over F, F over R is the subspace of F over F. That means 0 vector space and itself are the vector spaces of subspace of this subspace. If I take O over F, Orif is the subspace of ORF. That means it has only one subspace. If I take 0 vector space, that means it has only one subspace. Okay. If I take R over Q. R over Q, that means this is my vector space. Q over Q is not subspace of R over Q. Why? Because C is considered of R. I will just now I'll discuss it. C over Q is not subset of R over Q. Why? Because C is not subset of R. C is not subset of R. Next, C over Q is not subspace of Q over Q. C over C, Q is not subset of R. Why? Because C is not subset of Q. C over R is not subspace of R over R. But this vector space is already we know that C over R and R over R vector space. But R is see this is not subset of R, that's why C over R is not subspace of R over R. Since C is not subset of R, R over Q is not subspace of C Q over Q. Why? Because R is not subset of Q. Q over Q, R over Q, C over Q are not subspace of O over Q. Why? Because this is zero vectors, it only contains zero vector. These are not subset of zero. That's why these are not subspaces of O over Q. Zero vector space. That is R over R, C over R, C over C are not subset of C over, therefore that means over Q. R2 over R is a vector space. I'm going to multivariable. Here I'm taking that R2 over R is a vector space. Okay, we know that O over R, right? So over R, R2 over R, the trivial subspace of R2 over R. Yeah, so I'm taking this W R, right? W is equal to A comma 0, A belongs to R, R subspace of R2, and this. Then these are the non-trivial subspace of R2 over R. Why? Because so I'm explaining. So I'm taking here R2, right? What is R2? R2 R is a vector space. My R2 over R is a vector space. So how do you clarify this is R2, right? This R and this also R. R2 over and R, these are the vector spaces. Sorry, R2 over R2 and this. R2 over is the vector space. Already we know that. How would it look like R2? So I'm taking that. A comma B such that A comma B belongs to R. R2 is equal to A comma B such that A comma B belongs to R. So this is R2 equal to this is my set R2, right? So already we know that zero vector space. Zero nothing but it is look like in R2. What is zero here in R? Zero nothing but zero comma zero. The set which is containing zero element on, right? So this is over, that means zero over F, right? Zero vector space and zero over R is a vector space. Already we know that. And R2 over R both are subspaces of your, because R2 over is a vector space and is subset of R2 and over is subset of R. That means this subset of R, this subset of R2. So there means 0 vector space is subset of R2 and 0 over is a vector space. Therefore, these are the trivial subspace of R2 over R. this if I take R over R is not subspace of R2 over R. We are feeling that R2 subset of R, but already I explained that why it is not subset of R. Why? Because here my this R is not subset of R, not subset of R2. This R2. We know that these both are vector spaces. This is a vector space, this vector space. But this is not subset of R2 over R. Why? Because R is not subset of R2. Why? Because the elements of R2, see, if I take here, over that is R2 only. Okay. But the elements of R2 is in the form A comma B, but the elements of R is only one variable. That means the element of R is not in the form of A comma B. The elements of R is not in the form of A comma B. That's why this is not subset of R2, right? So the elements of form R2 are in the form of this phi. So, but we can write this R in R2 such that how can we write here A comma 0 such that A belongs to R. So this set you can take that W. Okay. So this set is real part, that means real line. So this is the you can observe that it is a subspace. Okay. And subset of R2. Same R I am written in the form of like this. So this R, that means this set subset of R2 and it is form vector space. That means next time is 0. Already we know that R2 is subspace. If you take here also, it's a subspace, so vector space. That means W subset of R2, this W over R is, so W over R is, W over R is subspace of R2 over R. Next, if I take other set, again I want to take other set, this is, I am taking W1, so this set maybe I will written here, the set, okay, I am writing here, instead of this, I am writing 0, comma, A, other can take B, whatever may be, so A, such that A belongs to R. Which is subset of R2? Which is subset of R2? This also, W1 over R also vector space. And which subset of subspace of R2? Up to now that then means so itself and 0 vector space are the trivial subspaces and this is the non-trivial subspaces, right? If you understand this, we will able to get other thing also. So now, so these are the trivial subspaces are the, okay, these are non-trivial subspaces of R2 over R. R over is not subspace of R2 over R. Just now I explained why, because R not subspace of R2. 0 vector space R3 over R, trivial subspace of R3 over R. If I take similar here, yeah, 0 vector space and R3 over R, the trivial subspace of R3 over R. If W1 equal W2, W3, if I take like this, just now I explained, these are the subspaces of R3 over R, and this falls, and W4, if I take the W4, AB 0, AB belongs to R, and 0 BC and J 0 C are the non-trivial, these are the non-trivial subspace of R3 over R. If I take Qn over Q, subset of R1 Q, subset of C1 C, if I take this, okay, so these are the subspace of R, these are the subspace of R, right? R1 over Q subset of Cn over R, R1 over R subset of Cn over R. So Pn is set of all polynomial, the subset of P over F, the set of all polynomial, right? The set of all polynomial of nth degree, Pf or the set of all polynomials. That means it has only nth degree polynomial, it has infinite many degree polynomial also, right? So note V over B vector space and W be a non-empty subset of V. The necessary and sufficient condition for W be a subspace of V is alpha belongs to beta, alpha comma beta belongs to W, which implies alpha plus beta belongs to W. Second one is A belongs to F, alpha belongs to W, which implies A alpha belongs to W. If it satisfies these two properties, then we say that W is subspace of V over F. So that means I am writing here, let V over be a vector space and W be a non-empty subset of V. The necessary and sufficient condition for so alpha comma beta plus W, and which implies alpha plus beta. Again, the theorem, that is A belongs to F and alpha belongs to W, which implies A alpha belongs to W. Let V over be a vector space and W be a subspace of V. The necessary and sufficient condition for W be a subspace of V is A alpha plus d beta plus W for all A comma belongs to F and A alpha comma beta plus W. So these are the very important theorem for the proving of subspace of any vector space. Why? Because these are the very useful in our class. So I'm going to explain here. So what is happening here? First of all, let two condition properties and W vector space and W be a non-subset of V, and the necessary sufficient condition for the W be a subspace of V is these two properties. Similarly, V over B vector space and W be a non-empty subset of V, the necessary and sufficient condition for W be a subspace of V is A alpha plus D beta plus W for all A comma B belongs to F and alpha comma beta belongs to F. So first one I am going to prove here, let V over B a vector space and W be a non-empty subset of V. So necessary condition, I am taking that W be a subspace of V over F. I want to prove that alpha comma beta plus W, and these two condition I want to prove that W is a subspace of U over F, which implies W is a vector space. W over F is a vector space. W over F be a vector space. If W over vector space, then what happens? It satisfies two conditions, all 10 properties. First one is simply considered W complex the abelian group, and W is a scalar product or vector composite property, it satisfies. So first one you can observe the alpha competence of W. That means W is a vector space, that is abelian group, it satisfies closure property. If I take any two elements in W, then alpha comma beta plus W, which implies alpha plus beta belongs to also W. So according to the closure property, so since W is closure, so first condition over. That means alpha comma beta W, which implies alpha plus beta belongs to W. First one is over. Second condition, A belongs to F, alpha belongs to W, which implies A alpha belongs to W. So W is subspace, vector space, external. That means by using the external composition property, what is there that W is the vector space over F, that means it has the external condition property, that external composition property. So that means what I am taking, scalar property or external composition property can use here. If I take any element in F and alpha plus W, which implies A alpha plus W, this is external composition property. So second one is proved. Necessary condition is over. Okay. So similarly, you can take that what you can take that I briefly explain the proof. So I want to take this, so now I want to prove that vector space, so subspace, sorry, V subspace of W subspace, W subspace of V. So for that, what can I take here? So I want to take that this, I want to take this property, I want to show that W subspace of V over F. So for this, I want to show that W is vector space itself. So I want to show that V comma W comma plus abelian group. First one, you can observe that if I take this, it is satisfied by closure property. Also associate property, all the elements of W is a vector is also element of W. So why? Because V is a vector space and all element of W is elements of W. So that means this also satisfies associative property. Third one, you can take that beta equal to some, yeah, from this you can take that A is equal to minus 1, alpha plus W. If I multiply this thing, it satisfies that way. What happens? Minus alpha plus W. So by using this, alpha and minus alpha plus W, and alpha plus minus alpha equal to 0, that means satisfy inverse property. So alpha minus alpha is 0, you know that means 0 belongs to W. So why? Because alpha comma minus alpha belongs to W, that equal alpha minus alpha is 0, 0 belongs to W. So alpha and rho 0 belongs to W, which implies alpha plus 0 also belongs to W. That is equal to it satisfies the inverse identity property also. So similarly, we can apply these things. So we can easily prove that this is a vector space. Okay. This is a brief idea. You can prove your own. Okay. Now I'm going to prove some problems. Let V be a vector space and W is a subspace of non-empty set two of V. W is a subspace of V if and only if. That means we use U in B. I had already used the alpha computer. Now I am going to prove that same property I am written here in place of alpha beta. I am writing U comma V. So for that, what I am taking here, V over B vector space, W a non-empty subset of V. We have W be a subset of V if and only if AU plus BB belong into V for all A comma B belongs to F and U comma B belongs to W. So no problem. Let R3 over R be a vector space and W is equal to this. Be a non-empty subset of R3, then show that W is a subspace of R3. So for showing W is a subspace of R3, I required some properties, right? Just now we said property. You use that property. I want to show that this is obvious, right? So by using by showing all properties, just if I show these two properties or single one property, it is easy to see that my vector space, right? So what is my set is given here? W is equal to x comma y comma z, right? So my set is so W has given that how it is W looking that x y z such that x plus so x plus 2y plus 3z equal to 0. I want to show that this is so I want to show that this is a subspaces of R3. I want to show that this is a subspace of R3. So clearly says that this is the form of R3 only. It must subspace because all elements of this form. So that means it's subset of R. Clearly it's subset of R3. Okay. I want to show that W is subset of R3. For showing W is subset of V, already just now we mentioned one theorem. So I'm taking that V over F is a vector space. So simply can say that V over F is a V over B vector space. V over B vector space and W be a non-empty subset, right? W is a non-empty subset, right? Because here some element, it is non-empty subset of this V. For showing W is subset of V, the necessary condition for this, so I'm taking two elements from here. So that means a u comma v belonging to here my f is r, right? I'm taking the r over r. My f is r. Okay, I want to write here r. Oh, okay, no need to write here. I can write f now because I want to use that. So for showing this, u comma v belongs to W. I am taking these two elements W. I am taking A comma B belongs to R. Why? Because here my vector space is R. Sorry, my field is R. So for showing this, I want to show that what can I show? AU plus BV. AU plus BV belong into R. AU plus BV belonging to W. Sorry, I want to show this for showing this thing, right? So for that, I am taking two elements in the set U1, UR. Okay, U equal to, you can take that. What is the U? एक्स वन वाई वन जेड वन, दिस इज टू ए वाई यू एंड वी इज इक्वल, यू कैन टेक दैट एक्स टू एक्स थ्री सॉरी एक्स टू वाई टू जेड टू, आई एम टेकिंग टू एलिमेंट्स इन डब्ल्यू. If I take any two elements in W, which property satisfies? So, if I take any two element W, it must satisfy x plus 2y plus 3z equal to 0. For that, I am taking a same, which implies so such a way. So, x1 plus 2y1 plus 3z1 equal to 0. Similarly, x2 plus 2y2 plus 2z2 so I'm writing this is star. Okay. So now I want to prove that AU plus BU, so it means A calculus, I will take that AU plus BU belongs to W. I want to show that. So for that, AU plus BV. So AU plus BV. AU nothing but you can take the AU nothing but x1 y. AU nothing but ax1 ay1 az1. BV nothing but ax2 by2 is az2. Right? I want to multiply this. I want to use here. So ax1 ay1 az1. Ax2, Bx2, By2, Bz2. If I add this thing, what happens? Ax1 plus Bx2. So Ax1 plus By, Bx2. Next, Ay1 plus By2. Next, Az1 plus by2 sorry bz2. Okay, this element, for showing this element belongs to W, AU plus BU is nothing but this element belongs to W. What can I show? This element satisfies so first element into plus 2 into this element and 3 into this element equal to 0, then we say that this element belongs into W. That means in the form of it is in the form of x, y, z. If it is satisfy x plus 2y plus 3z, x nothing but this, y nothing but this, z nothing but this, that means this plus 2 times of this plus 2 times of this plus equal to 0. Then you can observe here. So x times of this times plus 2 times of this time, right? So you can write here. So this term, you can write here this in place of this. This term, you can write here this term. So plus this. So I'm writing this. This time plus 2 times of this, right? What I'm doing now here, this ax1 plus bx2. I am 2 times of AY1 plus BY2 plus 3 times of AZ1 plus ZZ2. If I add this thing and apply all properties of vector spaces, then what can I do? Simply can do that. So first of all, I will take common out A here from these two terms. So what do you get here? So by using vector properties only, this can happen here. X1, if I take common AX1, 2 times of these are 2. If I take that, A common out there are 2Y1. A times of 3z1. Okay. If I take B, B common out first, what will get here? X2. Next to 2y2. Next to 3z2. So here a times of this and b times of this. So from star here can observe here x1 plus 2y1 plus 3z equal to 0 and x2 plus 2y2 z equal to 0. These are both are 0. Then what happened? This a times of 0 plus b times of 0. That equal to will get 0. That 0 plus 0 that equal to 0. Okay. So this AU plus BU satisfies vector satisfies. So vectors, okay, you can take the 0 bar. Okay, vectors that's part 0 bar you can take here. Here also you can take that 0 bar. No need to here 0 that means so okay, no not required here. You can take that so this AU plus BV equal to 0, that equal finally we get 0 bar only. This condition has satisfies. Right? AU, if I take that AU, this element, so it's not equal to this. So for showing this belongs to W, I want to verify that later I am taking this condition. Let consider, I am considering this plus 2 times of this plus 2 times of this, so we will get 0. That means this element satisfies the relation, therefore AU plus B belongs to which side? To W. So this belongs into W. So AU plus B plus W, therefore W is a subspace of R3 over R, right? W is subspace of R3 over R for all U comma belongs to W and A comma belongs to F. So this is the show how do we show that vector spaces, subspaces, right? Simply, I am now represent here R3 is a vector space and W is a subspace of this. So, I am taking U is equal to this such that condition is this. V if I take is this, condition is this. Let A comma belongs to R. AU equal to this and BV is equal to this. So, AU plus BV equal to observe here AX1 BY1 plus this. AU plus B nothing but if I add this to AX1 plus BX2, right? Considering this AX1 plus 2 times of this and this and this. This 2 times of this you can write multiply. By since V is R3 or vector space, all element belongs to vector space, we can add and all property associative and Abelian property, distributive property, observe if I observe here. So what we get here, AX1 plus 2Y1 plus 3Z1 that equal to 0, you can take that A equal to 0. That means this element satisfies 0 condition. So therefore, we say that W is subspace of R3 over R, W is subspace of R3 over R. So then the vector space Vn over is nothing but it is many. The vector space Vn over is nothing but it many Qn over Q or Rn over Q or Rn over R or Cn over Cn over R. That means in place of vector space you may take Vn over nothing but you may take that Rn over R, Q over Q, anything. F is any field, take that instead of this thing you may take anything, right? Similarly, I am taking that let V3 over F be a vector space and W is equal to this be a non-empty subset of V3, then show that W is not a subspace of V3 over F. If I take this, it is not a subspace of V3 over F. Given that V3 over F be a vector space and W is equal to XYZ such that X plus Y plus Z equal to 1 and X comma Y comma Z belongs to R be a non-empty subset of V3. So, same I am taking that U comma V equal to such that condition is this x1, y1, z1 equal to 1, x2, y2, z equal to this. I am taking that let a comma belongs to R, au is equal to a times of u, nothing but x1, y1, z1 that equal to x1, a, y1, a, z1, bv equal to bf, x2, y2, z2 that equal to bx2, by2, bz2, av plus bv is equal to what happen, ax1 plus ay1 plus az2 and bv nothing but bx2 plus bv, add to this thing, what have ax1 plus bx2, then this is a, b nothing but this. So consider I am x plus y plus z, x nothing but this, y nothing but this, z nothing but this. If I adding these things, so I am take common out all. Why? Because it is not easy to common out, but it satisfies the vector space condition. That's why you can have common out here. If I take a common out, then what happens? X1 plus y1 plus z1. So plus b common out, x2 plus y2 plus z2. So already we know that this is equal to 1 and this is equal to 1. A plus b, but a plus b are not equal to, right? B is equal to 1 minus a. So that means so a plus b will get here. So if it is get 1, then it happen. So but a plus b will get, it is not equal to 1 for b not equal to 1 minus a. So since b not equal to 1 minus a, so in this case it is not equal to 1. Therefore au comma bu does not belong into w for all a comma belongs to r and u comma w and au plus bu does not belong into w. Therefore w is not subspace of R3 over R, right? So this end the lecture 4. Thank you for watching this. Okay, thank you for watching this.